When you look at this, what do you normally think? What is it about? It's about a character hitting a sixer, right? See, believe it or not, students from Northeast India are hitting a sixer in their career. Today, I'm here to tell you about new age education and how we have integrated different media like animation. We've integrated media like film, film design, film studies. We've integrated, even we have brought in media like comic book designs and poster designs, visual arts into the mainstream curriculum. I'm working with some of the schools in Northeast now. I'm here in Guwahati. Like my students study the mainstream subjects like physics, chemistry, biology, English. But along with that, they're also studying about photography in their school. They're also studying about filmmaking in their school. They're making documentary films. They're going around during the weekends to the field trips. They're going to the villages. They're interviewing people and they're making films based on them. They're working on biodiversity. They're making survey reports. They're clicking a lot of photographs. They're clicking bugs. They're clicking birds. They're clicking whatnot. You'll find all kinds of cameras in their hands. But most importantly, you will seldom see SLR cameras. But they are being taught is a concept that to click good photographs, you really do not need an SLR camera. I'll begin with this photograph because I've been teaching photography to the students and this one aspect of it, like this is one of the photographs which I often use to teach them the concepts about composition, the concepts about the golden rule, the rule of thirds, the rule of intersection. As you can see over here, there's a curved line in the boy's body and also there are straight lines of the bat and the wicket. So these are very little concepts which I'm teaching the students in the school and they're coming up with such brilliant results. These are some of the poster designs which the students have done from the school. The first one is about literacy for all. The next one speaks about support the girl child. It's a concept based on that. Before we integrated the poster designs and visual arts into the mainstream curriculum, we did an action research which was very necessary in the classroom. See, in a class of 40, say there are 40 students, each one of them will have their own unique capabilities of expressing in a different manner. Some of them will be conveying through words, some of them will be conveying through their writings, some of them will be able to draw well, some of them will be able to act well, some of them will be able to sing, some of them will be able to dance. So what we did was, we gave the students the same assignment. It was based on literacy for all. We had just given them one punchline and support the girl child. Some of them had written beautiful essays on it, paragraphs. Some people had even composed poems on them and some came up with these brilliant visuals where they had hand-drawn these posters. It's very evident that the integration of visual language, the visual vocabulary, as you might call it, when it's integrated into the curriculum, it gives the students a better opportunity to express themselves in whichever they feel like. We have also included comic book designs within the mainstream curriculum. You might feel like, what is comic book doing in the mainstream curriculum? Like this was an assignment which was given to them, which was based on tiger conservation, and they were being asked to come up with their own ideas on how to propagate tiger conservation within the schools. The students have come up with this brilliant comic book design. Some of them found out to be very easy to communicate visually through their drawings, through their scribbles. You can see over here, it's a little boy who goes to the zoo and asks his father, do we have tigers only in the zoos? It's a very futuristic concept. Like if you're not saving tigers now, there will be tigers only in the zoos or maybe only in the museums as stuffed displays. We go back to the days of Amar Chitra Katha when the comic books used to teach us more about history than the mainstream history books. Are you familiar about Amar Chitra Katha? All the histories, the Rana Pratap, Surdas, We were very well versed with what history is all about. We are trying to revive the same thing within the school's curriculum. The students are developing their own comic books. They're communicating it visually. And these comic books created by the students are being translated into the mainstream, the main Indian languages, and also the vernacular languages in every state, so that people from every state are able to comprehend, are able to find out what stories the students are trying to convey. This is an extension of what we have done with the existing history books of the Northeast. See, there are three early men, they are conversing amongst themselves. One of them is saying, like, so does our history, study of history, end here? One of them is saying, certainly not. After studying about the great Indus Valley civilization, the Aryans, Mauryans, we must know something about Assam. So it sets an introduction comic strip for a book on Assam's history, which is coming up in that same comic book form. It just builds up their interest. We are transforming the textbooks, which sometimes the students feel that they are very drab, they are uninteresting. There are no pictures. Remember our old days, like when we were 2 to 3 years old, our parents used to give us books filled up with pictures. As we as students grew up, the pictures vanished from the books. It was more text-based. There were hardly any drawings. There were hardly any pictures. It became difficult for us, and it was a task for us to visualize everything in our mind because nothing was given in front of us. I'll show you a video clip. It's an animated video clip. And we have integrated, we have brought in animation within the mainstream curriculum as well. It's actually a very powerful medium for communication. So let's watch the clip and then I'll be able to tell you what it's all about.
मरीज को कहीं भेजा जाए जहां मिले आराम
लहर ठंडी हो हवा की ऐसा शांति धाम सिंपल कोई हिल स्टेशन
अरे वो अक्कल के दुश्मन
सबके सबके सब पहाड़ खोद कर डाले उखाड़ अब तो बस मैदान है मेरा रेगिस्तान है
चले सागर किनारे हो सके हालत सुधारे
बालू में बैठा थका हार कर क्यों रोता है गोपी चंदर
बालू में बैठा थका हार कर क्यों रोता है गोपी चंदर शहर भरा अब हरा समुंदर
तड़पे मछली जल के अंदर
पॉली थैलिया कालीन बनाया
गंभीर है
As you can see on screen, the message said reuse, recycle, something like that. So this was a concept which was given to a lot of schools in Mumbai. This animation film was developed in Mumbai. Nowadays, every school is screaming about being green. There's a new concept which has come, we have to be green schools. The students are being taught different concepts about global warming, about environment change, climate change, all these things. Some schools in Mumbai, they were being taught the same concept. But what we did, we brought in animation and taught the children of the school how to make their drawings come alive through animation. This was an example of a hand-drawn animation which the school students had done. Everything you had seen over here except the editing part. Even the editing part was done within the school by the students only. Because along with the introduction of a new subject, the new curriculum of media studies, animation within the mainstream curriculum, what we are trying to create in each school is we are trying to create a very small production studio over there, where there will be editing suits. The students will be using basic softwares in editing. They will be producing their own film, all the dialogues, all the narration part, they'll be recording there itself, and they'll be integrating it along with their film. I'll show you another video. This video was the result of training in filmography, the concepts of filmmaking, for only 1 month. The students were taught on various concepts on storyboarding. They were being taught how to handle a basic camera. See, they had used all simple cameras. No fancy video cameras were used in making of this film. They were being given normal cameras. And they were also being given a training on how to edit the film, how to put things together, how to integrate your storytelling. So this was a result.
Friends and fellow students, we have gathered here today to stand as one to protest the death of Raj, a brilliant young man whose brilliant life was cut short by hooligans who knew no better. They say they were having fun bullying a fellow mate. But are we really going to stand by and watch as more and more of these young men are getting ruined year after year?
We have the strength, the power, and the vision to make a difference in the world. We will fight to create an environment in the campus where everyone will have the freedom to grow.
Let us awake to a new dawn. Let us not give up hope. We can make a difference with our vision, imagination, and creativity.
So let us carry it forward and not ruin it. Let no one break our confidence, our views, our opinions, our thoughts, but instead extend our horizons and look for the new.
So let us resonate this message to all the cities and colleges in the country. We shall not keep silent. We shall not keep quiet. Let us raise our voice against the system and rebel until actions are taken against the unjust. We want justice.
Justice.
We want
justice.
We want justice.
Everything you saw over here in this particular film clip, the documentary film was developed within a school. The students had shot the film, they had put everything together, they had done the narration, they had done the music, they composed the music, they edited the film, the final product was released. And this film had won a silver medal at the UNIS UN, a flagship students conference, international student conference, which is organized by the United Nations last year. So the question comes, like, how we are going to integrate, how we are going to begin in our own homes? How can we bring in these media into the mainstream learning process of a particular student? Yes, we can do it. It's important for us to find out what our children are good at. See, the career and being a professional, everyone is after those concepts nowadays, but it's very important to make happy professionals who are well versed with their own careers. They've chosen a career path in whatever they are good at. It's the most primary thing. That is why we have introduced this new age education. So let's strive for happy professionals for tomorrow, and let's give the power of sun in the palm of their tiny hands. Thank you.